Can I travel to the Philippines from the U.S.? There have been a lot of rumors flying around that the Philippines has opened up to tourist travel, and hopefully this will be true soon, but for now, there are still a lot of criteria and different circumstances by which the Philippines may or may not allow entry. So today's report will be focused on U.S. travel to the Philippines. All of this in today's G5 News, Philippines Daily News Report. Hello and welcome to today's Friday, December 10th, Daily Philippines News Report. And yes, I do live in the Philippines, and despite best efforts to soundproof, I'm not sure what's going on with the neighborhood and these dogs the last two or three days. But if you are subscribed to our channel, then welcome back. And if not, please consider subscribing right now to stay up to date on news bits that I follow here in the Philippines. And if you find these reports informative, please click that like button. All right, so can we travel to the Philippines? The short answer is it depends. U.S. citizens who are residents of the Philippines or hold a long-term Philippine visa and already have valid travel visas may enter the Philippines and will not be required to quarantine when entering from the United States. However, currently, visa issuance for U.S. citizens has been suspended until further notice. And as of now, for tourist or 9A visa entry, these remain suspended. But I would always contact your local Philippines Bureau of Immigration office just to verify based on your personal circumstances. Now, there are several criteria that one must meet to travel from the U.S. to the Philippines. The Philippines is maintaining a list of countries categorized as low, medium, and high risk, with green being the lowest, yellow in the middle, and red the highest. Risk in this situation refers to the COVID-19 rate of incidents and case counts. And you can check the Philippines Bureau of Immigration website to see what your country is currently classified. I list links to all of my resources in the description below. The United States is currently classified as yellow, and I will go through the requirements. So, okay, first, if you are vaccinated, these are the requirements, and I will get to partially and not vaccinated next. So again, if you are fully vaccinated, travelers are required to show a negative RT-PCR test taken within 72 hours from departure. Additionally, a three-day facility-based, and now this is important, guys, a three-day facility-based quarantine will be required while awaiting an additional RT-PCR test. If you arrive without a negative RT-PCR test, you will be required to quarantine in a government-approved facility for 5 days and the release of a negative test result. A facility-based quarantine means you must stay at a state-approved and dedicated property specifically for quarantining. The Filipino Bureau of Quarantine has provided a list of these approved facility-based quarantine accommodations, which you can access on quarantine.doh.gov.ph. And I will list the link in the description below. Additionally, 14 days of self-monitoring beginning the day of arrival is required. Self-monitoring means you must actively watch for symptoms of COVID-19. Partially vaccinated, unvaccinated, or unverifiable vaccination status, travelers who are unvaccinated, partially, or unable to verify are required to undergo facility-based quarantine for 7 days and until the release of their negative test results. Once released, a home quarantine of 14 days from the time of arrival is mandatory. Countries on the red list cannot enter the Philippines. As of November 30, 2021, inbound international travelers coming from a red list country or travelers who have been to a red list country within the last 14 days prior to arriving in the Philippines cannot enter the country regardless of vaccination status. However, Filipinos coming from the 14 countries covered by the travel ban, due to the Omicron variant, may still come home to the Philippines through repatriation flights. And this is according to the Bureau of Immigration. Now, the only concern with that is that flights coming from countries under the red list are still suspended. So they would have to enter the Philippines through repatriation flights, either government or non-government initiated repatriation flights. You might ask why am I mentioning this. It's because in some cases, Filipinos might be accompanied by their American spouse, and with the proper long-term visa, may, I'm not saying for sure, but may be able to enter accompanied by their Filipino national spouse. But don't take my word for this. Be sure to check with the Philippines Bureau of Immigration prior to travel. And I highly suggest that if you're traveling from the U.S., be sure to not connect through any of the red list countries, even though I have found information stating that if you have transited through a red list country but did not leave that country's airport, you will be allowed to transit through the Philippines. Now, in order to get one of these repatriation flights, you will need to coordinate with the nearest Philippine embassy or consulate to assist you in registering for one of the repatriation flights. Another option may be to travel to another country that is not listed on the red list, then book a flight back to the Philippines. But be assured, the Bureau of Immigration has stepped up its manpower and is fully prepared to conduct 100% passport inspection to check the travel history of all arriving passengers within the last 14 days. And if found to have come from the 14 travel restricted countries and are foreign nationals, you may not be allowed entry into the Philippines. But Filipinos will be referred to the Bureau of Quarantine for the strict implementation of the 14-day quarantine. And as I said earlier, for foreigners, our only hope will be if they allow us in on our long-term permanent resident visa. Just do your diligence before you buy a plane ticket. Now, for the green list countries, the requirements are listed as follows. If you are fully vaccinated, travelers arriving from green countries must take an RT-PCR test at least 72 hours before their flight departs. No facility-based quarantine is required, but 14 days of self-monitoring is recommended. And for partially vaccinated, unvaccinated, or unverifiable vaccination, travelers in this category must undergo a 5-day facility-based quarantine. They will be released on the 5th day as long as their test results come back as negative. Plus, 14 days of self-monitoring for symptoms will also be required. Okay, so that is my Friday, December 10th news update for the day. Thank you so much for watching. I will be back again on Monday with more Philippines news updates on what's happening in the Philippines. Be sure to check the description below where I list links to my various resources. And while you're at it, click that like button. I sincerely appreciate it. And feel free to drop a line in the comments with questions or topic suggestions. God bless us all. Stay tuned, and we'll see you in the next video.